Hi guys, I'm Manpreet and welcome to a new reading vlog. Today is Monday and I just finished reading this book, The Secrets We Keep by Sudeep Nagarkar. I'm just amazed with the fact that this author has been published several times and this is not your first book and this is what you get in this book. This is what people are reading. Honestly, if you're reading a book like this, you seriously need better books. And I'm not saying in terms of how easy the book is to read, okay? I understand that we as Indians, English is not a first language and we like to read English books and we want to read more books. And even reading books is difficult to begin with. So we want to get our hands over an easy to read book, but an easy to read book doesn't have to be a pathetic book. Okay, an easy to read book can be a good book as well, so that is what you should be picking. And a book like this, it just makes me cringe. It's just horrible at every single level. Okay, I would say that there is one more book that I read this year which was really bad. Apart from all the things that were bad in it, it also was very insulting to women. It also was very problematic in terms of how the male characters in that book behaved towards women and how it was shown as love or how it was shown as something that was right. I found that very problematic in that book. But this book, at least the women characters in this book get some respect. It is not problematic in that way, but when it comes to writing and the whole story, it's just, it follows this intelligence officer Rahul who is on a secret mission, and then he falls in love with this girl during his secret mission, and then after some time she's kidnapped and you have to find out what all happens to her or who kidnaps her and what goes wrong and everything like that. To begin with, you see Rahul's backstory and how his relationship was with his parents, and there is no consistency in it. It's all just cringeworthy at every single level. These characters, oh my god, these characters are so stupid. This intelligence officer causes another intelligence officer to ask her about, oh my god, there's a bomb in my car, what should I do? Throughout this whole book, it has been established that there was only one person witness to this event happening between these two people. And by the end of the book, this person was like, oh my god, who could have done this? Who could have done this? Who could have done this? Like, there were three people in this scene, so you cannot even think that that person might be it, okay? That person is out of question and you're like, tell me who did it, tell me who did it, tell me who did it. Like, what are you, dumb? This intelligence officer is actually dumb. The whole book is actually so. The bigger problem is that if your character acts in a particular way, it may be out of character, but it's still at some level not as cringeworthy as it gets in this book, because you make your character do this stupid thing and then you establish that this character is very good at working under pressure. That's why he's calling some other person and asking about, what should I do? I have a bomb in my car. And that person, there is nothing complicated in this whole book, okay? That person just says, this person, that, you know what? Get out of the car right now. Like, wow! It took a very good intelligence officer to call another intelligence officer to figure this out. Wow. Honestly, I mean, if I start talking about all the things which were bad in this book, it would take forever. Such a bad writing, such a bad way of telling a story, such a bad set of characters. I'm just amazed. I'm not even like disgusted or anything. I'm just amazed at how it's such a popular author and how it's not even the first book of that author, because your first few works can be bad, okay? One, it's one of the latest works and it's this bad. It's just amazing. It's just amazing. What do I say about this book? I would give it 1 out of 5 stars. I wish I could give it 0.5 or 0, because I don't think anybody should be reading trash like this. There are good books out there, easy to read, funny, entertaining, good books out there. You can pick those up. You do not have to go through this torture. And I'm just thinking about all these people who are beginning as readers And I would say that 90% of them would be just appalled with such a work and would never pick up a book again. So I am really heartbroken at the fact that a book is ensuring that a person doesn't become a reader, because honestly, you have to be really like stupid and really new to the world of storytelling and movies and books to be able to like a work like this. And secondly, the 10% of the people who will like this book and think that that's how the books are and they will enjoy it. You guys are just missing so much on your life. You will spend your hours on this book while there are amazing books out there waiting for you. And you will never get to discover those books because you never realize that this is bad work. This is horribly bad work. The scenes are just kiddish. The language is as if author is writing this book for people who don't even understand language. The characters are bad. The situations are stupid. The way they react to the situations are stupid. The whole plot is stupid. Everything about this book is stupid. It's trash. Dialogues, conversations, events, everything is so, I would say naive as a word would be insulted if I use that word. It's just downright stupid. Sorry. It's just plain stupid. And honestly, I do not mean to offend the people who are Sudeep Nagarkar fans. I understand if you are a fan, it's fine. But I just did not like this book. And maybe he has written better books, which are something which you can read and which you have enjoyed in the past. Or maybe you need to discover better books. So please know that if you are feeling offended with my review for this book, it's not about you, it's about me, it's about how I felt. And it's about how I feel like such books do to people. If you feel differently, it's your opinion and you get to share it with whoever you want. Like I get to share my opinion with whoever I want on my channel, at least, where I want people to read better books, where I want people to discover good books, where I want people to fall in love with reading and not feel disgusted about reading books. Guys, I have been reading Cross Her Heart by Sarah Pinborough, and it's a UK based writer, and I have heard that she is quite a famous writer. I have no idea about it. I just got this book probably from HarperCollins publisher. I just got this book and I have been reading it. I am done with 132 pages of this book. I have been reading slowly, and also I'm reading other books as well. I did not make any progress with it. I was listening to Harry Potter book 1 on Audible because I just love Harry Potter audiobooks, and I just listened to them from time to time but never finished them. This time I do intend to finish them because this is the perfect time to start reading Harry Potter books. Not really perfect because it's really hot in India at this time, but if you can do it in 2 months, okay, then start reading Harry Potter from the end of October. If you are sure you will take time to read these books, then it is the right time to start reading Harry Potter novels. So if you want to read with me, just go ahead, pick up books on Audible, or you can just, you know, pick up the good old paperback and read them. So I have been reading this one. About this book, I have started with the part 2, and it's, let's just see how that goes, okay? I have started reading this book. I'm done with like about 9 pages. Though it's a 200 page book, but there's a lot of text, okay, on per page. And I'm excited to be reading it. So guys, I think you know that I'm going through a reading slump. And I have been having a hard time picking up a book that I actually want to read. So I'm trying different strategies here. These 4 are the books that I have been reading. So I'm going to read a couple of pages from these, then a few pages from this. Like a little bit of reading that will be better than no reading, right? Discussing about actual reading, not the reading slump, not the bookshelf cleaning. I have been reading Cross Your Heart and I'm done with 150 pages of this book. Honestly, it's sort of like a thriller. And there was a twist, a little bit of it, but it isn't making me go wow. It isn't making me go like, oh my god, I really want to be reading this. It's just that something I am reading, I am liking it, and it's fine. Okay, I actually want to read it, but there's nothing that I am liking very, very much that will be amazing and that will make me go wow. Listen, the moment after I said this is just like something I'm not liking much and blah blah blah, just got so interesting. I have already read 30 pages since the time I filmed my last update, and I want to continue reading. It's so interesting right now. Hi guys, this is Manpreet from the future, and this is the end of the reading vlog. So basically, I finished reading two books last week. One is The Secrets We Keep by Sudeep Nagarkar, which was a highly disappointing book. And secondly, I read Cross Her Heart. Honestly, you do not see a lot of clips of this book, but actually, it was night time. I started flipping through a few pages and then I just could not sleep until I finished this book. So it was really exciting to see this book and the twists that come up, and there are things that you could not guess. For a large part of this book, I felt like I knew who is who, and I felt like I knew everything, and I felt like, oh my god, it's just so predictable. But it is not at all predictable, and I just got the whiff of it quite early in the book. I would say after like about 200 pages, which made it a very exciting journey to read this book and enjoy this book. And it was a perfect read for a Sunday night, and I'm just so happy. Because, you know, sometimes when you pick up a book, you are not expecting much from it, and then you're not even enjoying it, but then there is this point after which you're like, oh my god, I am going to read this book, I'm going to finish it, I don't care about Grey's Anatomy right now, I don't care about any TV show, I don't care about any activity, I just need to read the book. That's what happened with me with this book. So yeah, all in all, these two books are the ones that I read last week, even when I was in a reading slump. So, and I really hope that you enjoyed watching this reading vlog. It was quite simple in comparison to what I usually like to do. But I still hope you enjoyed watching it. And if you did, make sure you hit a thumbs up. If you're new here, please make sure you subscribe. And yeah, that's it. And do not forget to tell me what you read last week, okay? So comment down below right now. This might be signing off. I'll be back with another vlog very soon.